You ever look at a QR code and think, what if it was more spirally, or like a mountain? Yeah, me neither, but somehow this video exists. Alright, let's do it. Generate a QR code that contains some text, but also looks as close as possible to a target image. So I need to figure out how to generate QR codes beyond just, oh, put stuff in a form and something comes out. How do they really work? So surely there's a definitive spec for this, and I'm meant to pay for this. This is a bit where I'd run an ad or something, but I'm too small for that. Anyway, I have bought a copy of the spec. It raises more questions than it answers, but mostly not important ones. Hey, where were we? Right, pictures. The first thing to know about QR codes is that they're redundant. This segment here contains error correction bits, which can be used to compensate for misreading or damage. You've probably seen this in action with QR codes where the middle is removed for branding or whatever. That's just damage. There are four different error correction levels, and the highest, H, can theoretically recover up to 30% damage. That's not a guarantee. I think it depends on where the damage is and what it looks like. That part's where all the crazy math is, and I don't feel like looking that deep into it. But at least we know we can mangle some of the pixels and it still scans fine. But that's like a tiny portion of the area, so surely there's something better. I mean, look how much runtime we have left. Maybe this is it. Data masking. So after laying out the data and the error correction bit, the result is fed through one of eight masks, based mostly on whichever one balances best between light and dark in the output. Which is good in general, improves reliability, but might not be what we're looking for here. What if we instead choose a mask based on which one gives a result closest to our target image? It's not that much closer, actually. It was worth a shot. At some level, storing data means storing data. Obviously, we can't just put whatever pixels we want and expect it to read as coherent text. But at this scale, a lot of the space is being taken up by padding blocks. You see, this size of QR code has a lot more data capacity than I actually need. So the spec says the rest should be filled up with these bytes. But what if we just don't? Indeed, it seems like readers don't care. So now that we know that, I can write some code to reverse the layout algorithm, generate some dynamic padding bytes, and would you look at that? Combine this with the intentional damage from earlier, and this is a lot better than I expected, actually. So we've got a novel way to display black and white images. Of course I played Bad Apple on it. And I'm not going to include the whole thing here, you can scan the code if you care. And yes, that is a QR code that links to a YouTube video of itself. Apparently if you start an upload and it immediately fails, you still get an ID and then can resume upload with a version that includes that ID. So that's fun. Anyway, I think this adventure wraps up about now. There are plenty of other weird things you could do with QR codes, but that's it for now. See you next time.